YouTube, what the crap's going on? Welcome back to the Sassanid campaign on Total War Attila, where we're going to continue where I had left off last time. We captured Amida here from the Eastern Romans with relative ease. Again, I'm not expecting a huge threat out of the Eastern Romans, even though they are a large faction, just because they're going to have a very difficult time securing their borders. And really just want to go ahead and push to Edessa and hold temporarily, and then we may go on to see if we want to invade Antioch or any of the other settlements that they hold. But of course, you know, I'm trying to do this in a way that gains me power but doesn't get me too exposed to pushback from other factions. Horde factions and stuff can be a pretty big threat if they catch you off guard, as you can not really have a whole lot of time to react to such a potentially large army that's coming at you. So let's go ahead and upgrade a couple of these town centers with what money we have. The rest of this can wait. And let's see if we can end our turn. We have unassigned skills. So let's see, this guy is a general, and he's gained some skill obviously by going after the Romans. So we could add another one here, which would give us plus two melee unit plus two experience for melee unit recruits. Not bad. If we go here, we can get cunning, and he actually gains some public order in the local province, which could be helpful to turning things around. So let's actually start with that. And let's see, from here we get authority and gives me more campaign movement range. And this one over here gives my men more melee defense and plus six morale. Wow. But that's for a governed province. That's for a commanded force, and this guy's going to be a commander, so we probably want to stay away from this line. Well, it's kind of weird how the governed force is mixed with commanded force. Seems like they might want those two trees separate, just as a suggestion moving forward. Seems like it would make that a little cleaner, because they're either going to be a governor, I don't know, they could end up being both, I guess. I'll try not to make judgment on that yet, but let's see, so that gives him, let's go with this again. Just boosting the public order, and same thing here, this general will boost the public order first, so might as well kind of get some freebies there. I do have my timer running this time. I didn't even time the last one that I filmed, so hopefully I'll get into that nice swing of roughly 25 minute videos here, so that it's in nice digestible chunks. We can get a little bit done each time. I think in this campaign we're going to start off and just go for a minor victory, because I'm sure you all want to see some other campaigns as well, so I don't want to drag it out forever. I will keep the save files, of course, and later on if we want to go further, we can. But I'm going to shoot for a minor victory, and I'll show you those objectives here. That's just one of my puppet states moving through, so no big concern to see those armies going there. Tribute. Brought a gift for my people in order that we may improve relations. Engage in faction politics to deal with the subject. So let's see what we've got here. So we got this guy. Greetings, I brought a gift for my people in order that we may improve our relations. Have him killed, the messenger included. Clearly these men are spies. Well, who would say no to such a generous gift or ignore such a noble gesture? Let's try and see what happens if we accept the gifts. No idea what's going to happen. Probably nothing huge, but you know, we can keep an eye on it. So the upgraded camel farms here, we probably don't need it just yet. Let's go ahead and do this one that unlocks Sogdian warriors, and then we'll move from there. But yeah, that one requires a little bit of cashola actually, so I'll try not to spend all my money on this turn. In fact, we can just go ahead and run through another turn real quick and get that done. And whatever money I have left, I'll just use it towards buildings on the next turn. Because we do have enough food to go ahead and do some expansion. Now, food does not work the same in this game. It's similar as it is in Rome 2, but the numbers are very different. So when you see me up there with a 312 food surplus, it's not like a 312 food surplus on Rome 2. Because the buildings will sometimes use 100, 200 food. It just depends. Some of them use small amounts like 20, 30, 40. So yeah, that's why the food is the way it is. So it looks like we have some enemy factions approaching Nisbis, and then we've got some approaching some of our client states as well. But they can handle their own, or not client states, puppet states. They can handle their own, and we'll attack that force that's moving in on Nisbis. And I have reinforcements at Ctesiphon as well in case they're needed. So we can add another governor now, and I do need to get some agents recruited as well. Agents work quite a bit different in this game as well. I haven't really gotten a ton of time to mess with them yet. This is the Sassanids, so These guys are the ones that are a puppet state of the East Romans, and clearly they think that they're going to get a piece of me here. So I could move from Ctesiphon up here to Nisibis and easily protect it with this force here. I don't think the Sassanids would be able to overcome what I have. And I could hire some mercenaries as well if I want, but let's go ahead and attack the Sassanids here. We should get potentially... Oh, we're outside the reinforcement zone. Let's see what they've got here. Desert Levy, which I don't think are going to be any good. Camel Warriors. I don't have any melee cav, which is kind of irritating. I think we can take these guys, though, so let's put the fight on. I think my Armenian spears are going to be a lot hardier than their desert guys, but I have no idea. I do have Svarin Cataphracts, though, so I feel like from a cavalry standpoint, I can inflict some major damage to their infantry. Let's see if we can get not in the fog here. Here we go. I want to be able to see what I'm doing. So I'm just going to put a line of Armenian spears. And these desert raiders are not very heavy cav, but they are fast, and they're camels, I believe. Yeah, well, these guys are horsemen. Let's take a look at the camels. Yeah, those camel warriors are not what I want to get engaged with when it comes to my shot cav. And then they've got desert tribesmen here, which don't look very good. And their desert levy looks like lesser than my Armenian spear. So we'll see what we can do. They do have me out skirmished. So yeah, I do have horse archers, though. That, you know what? Let's use these guys to our advantage. Let's see what we can do to the... Let's see what we can do to the computer with their horse archers. See if we can go bait them into some bad engagements. If we can, like, lure their cav out ahead of their army or something, that would be brilliant. So I'm just going to stand my ground for now. We're going to have to watch out for their hurlers. These guys do have range on my horse archers. At least I think they do. Game's paused. Let's hit this real quick and see what the range is on these horse archers. Probably 125, I'm guessing. No, they have 150 range. Yeah, 150 range. So I can't match the range of the hurlers, but still probably not an engagement I want to waste time. The horse archers don't have Parthian shot either, so I can only fire head-on. Let's go into a flaming shot because it'll be good against enemy cav. Let's see if we can start picking away at some of their melee cav. AI doesn't like me sending these horse archers up. I'll take all these units and just move them a little closer, just in case support's needed, but don't really want to engage yet. Yeah, see all the enemy cavs just kind of turning. Let's see what our speed is. We're only 100 speed, so these desert raiders are actually probably our primary concern. We can outrun everything besides the desert raiders, and that's going to be tricky. In fact, we may want to get a couple of Svarin Cataphracts out here. In case we need to interrupt an incoming charge. Let's go off fire at will. Target the desert warriors with some flaming shot. Enemy generals coming out here too, desert chieftain. It's a decent unit. I probably should have made sure I got reinforcements to make sure we had this fight, but this will be fun. It'll give me a challenge and give you a chance to see whether or not the game's going to push me from a standpoint here. Whoa, we're going to have to get out of here. Got hurlers inbound. Got a nice volley off. Let's get out of here before the hurlers can return fire. This is what we're looking for, though. We really want to harass the enemy into an attack, and it seems like the AI is taking the bait. Let's turn these guys onto fire at will now and just see what we can do from range. Again, we're going to have to keep our distance from the... Go ahead, fire, please. Fire, please. Fire, please. This is the problem with not having Parthian shot. You can see how difficult it is to get horse archer volleys off. This is going to be something that I think this game's going to struggle with. We can outrun the camel warriors. I'm going to pull my cataphracts back and let my spearmen take this charge here. Let's see how well they do against a... Oh, no, the desert raiders are getting hammered. Let's countercharge the desert raiders here. And let's... bring more cav in to assist. We're getting our Armenian spears attacked over here against desert mounted skirmishers. Kind of fold up Let's keep one unit over here. The general needs to countercharge here. We routed one unit, forcing the other to retreat, so we'll give chase, keep our horse archers ahead. And we're going to come in here into this fight to support our other Armenian spear as well. So we've managed to rout some of the desert cav units. My Svarin Cataphract's not going to want to stay in this fight unsupported. Target the hurlers. Let's get my front set up here. Okay. Managing to do some damage here. Still got some desert riders around that I'm not really wanting to deal with. Let's turn off the fire at will here so we don't kill our own guys. We're going to definitely need to get Svarin Cataphracts free for some rear charges. This enemy melee cav on that flank's a little bit concerning for me. We're going to have to get our Svarin Cataphracts out of here. We got to get them into rear charges and get them there quickly. Okay, my front line's only going to hold so long. And we've got some of these units out here in trouble. Here we go. Let's take these units. Put them on skirmish and fire at will over here. My general mopped up this fight. Let's see if we can wrap these guys real quick. Take our general through. So Armenian spears are holding, actually holding quite valiantly in the center. Let's pull back our archers a little bit, switch them to flaming, and get them to firing at the enemy general. And let's use our own general to go kill some of these skirmishers. We're going to have to probably just ignore that camel warrior. We're actually starting to get it to rout just from being attacked in the rear. Okay, Armenian spears push back over here. That's perfect. Let's attack that skirmisher cav. And let's get one more rear charge on these camel warriors, probably put them out of the game. Our general's going to chase off the desert bows. The infantry line is holding. And I don't want to do friendly fire damage. The enemy general's right here, and so I'm going to have to be careful. And my general's catching those desert bows. We've routed their camel warriors with a couple of cycle charges. And now their their camel warriors are coming after me. We did rout their skirmish cav. Let's split up here and see if we can get some shots on the camel warriors. And once my cataphracts get into the back of that fight, it's going to be over. So let's use the draw thing here. There we go. Got all my rear charges lined up. Let's turn our general on and get in this fight. So let's see how well this works using the drawing tool. So my guy's doing okay-ish. They're tired too, exhausted. So we're probably going to have to cycle out here. And I'm going to get better charges over here. At least I should. I think they're getting their charge order a little late on that drawing thing. So it's going to not work out as good in that case. We managed to get rid of their guys over here. Let's get our horse archers back into the fight. We'll charge those spears real quick. They weren't very braced. My general is out here just mowing down enemy skirmishers. We should be able to run a rear charge now with our cataphracts. Yeah, so now see, they're going to get a better charge. And that's going to be pretty crushing even though they're exhausted. We're going to get lots of kills. Svarin Cataphracts. The enemy general is still alive and he's actually disengaged a little. Let's pop him with flaming arrows, which have a bonus versus cav. Freaking camel warriors over here are not wanting to die. We broke their main infantry line though, and we just got some good shots on their general, and my own horse archers are out here firing on their spears. Let's rear charge this enemy general while I've got him pinned with my own general. So the Svarin Cataphract's going to deliver some rear charge penalties and damage. That ought to work out pretty good. A head-on charge against those units with the Svarin Cataphracts would have been less worthwhile. So we are going to defeat the Sassanids here, but they did put up a decent fight. I even just lost that Cataphract unit, unfortunately. But they rallied back in, and let's deliver a rear charge. Let's cease fire with the archers because we're getting friendly fire. Okay, we broke those spears. Looks alright. So it looks like the remainder of the Sassanid troops are going to be destroyed. So, managed to achieve success here. That's good. I did some things decent there. Their camel warriors definitely held up my cataphracts a lot longer than I wanted. You can see the one cataphract probably getting some nice rear charges. 202 kills. Alright, so we're going to defeat the Sassanids, send them packing. They actually have some units that are okay-ish versus mine early on. So you can take on warriors, which is a new feature that helps your replenishment, which is pretty cool. But it does hurt their experience levels to bring in these raw recruits. But at this point in time, I'm going to go ahead and do it because it's going to get me quite a bit of replenishment done in my units. So basically what you're doing there is taking on captives, and whatever captives are willing to fight with you can do so. And I don't know if we can actually finish these guys off on this turn as well. Yeah, we'll just wait and catch up with them. They're not going to do anything substantial against me with what pitiful force they have left here. So that was pretty great. Managed to push back the Sassanids. This is a very fertile land, and although I'd love to drop another farm building here, let's go ahead at this point and put in a town commons to get a little bit of public order, and then let's go ahead and convert these Roman... that one can't be converted, we just need to tear it down. So, and then we can upgrade that wheat field there. So a good spend of our money. Again, Sassanids defeated in battle. Their province is right here, I believe. No, right here. So it's way down here in the desert. Really don't feel like messing with those guys. Perhaps, though, if we can beat them up badly enough, they'll sue for peace. And that would be okay with me at this point. Minus 2 upkeep, minus 2% upkeep cost for all units. That wouldn't be too bad. It's going to be kind of tricky to get to these Dalemite warriors. Let's go ahead... Adobe Maker. Let's go ahead and get the upgraded camel farms at this point. And if we go back into our fertile provinces, we can actually upgrade the wheat farm, but let's hold off a little bit because the public order here is not so great. In this province, though, where the public order is quite good, no reason to not just go ahead and upgrade these wheat farms here. And to be honest, I'm not sure I really want this building here. I'm going to tear it down and replace it with one that does more sanitation, just to kind of see how that plays in. Got really not so great public order back here in Spahan. So we probably need to dedicate some money to upgrading this on the next turn, and that should fix the public order issue there. And then we should probably get rid of the sacred site and replace it with something more useful as well. So let's do that, and that should clear up what's going on there a little. So Shapur has access to new abilities. Melee defense skill for commanded force could be handy. Movement range I think would be even handier, so I'm actually going to drop those skills there. So now he's got plus 20% movement range on the campaign map. We can increase his army recruitment capacity to, well, it's a governed thing. Both of those are governed. And this actually is kind of like Dread almost. But we'd have to get a long ways down here, down to get it. This replenishment one might be a good one to go after next. So we'd get plus 6 replenishment to commanded force, which would be pretty handy. We're going to start the guy out again with the public order skills. You can see that being helpful. Xerxes Vengeance now has the ability to pick up some new traits. This makes us immune to desert attrition over here. So I think I'm going to unlock that first. So let's do that, and we'll get a little bit of immunity to desert attrition starting right off. There's a lot of desert around here, so that seems like it would make sense to me. Let's see what these guys are. Relentless Attacker, Taskmaster, Leader. That's probably going to do just as good as anything else. Let's put him in here. So now have all of our provinces governed, and we can issue an edict there, which I'm going to go with the Growth Edict again. To try and fill out all the building spaces in our province. We'll just see how that works. Different factions seem to have access to different edicts. The Sassanids don't have any that affect food, I noticed, but some of the others aren't bad. So at least we're getting a couple of nice battles so far into the campaign, enjoying that. I like seeing that the client states are doing a little participating, the Sassanids for the East Romans coming after me. And they darn near came into a good position. Nisibis would have been open, but fortunately I managed to head them off.
and I humbly request.
Yeah, non-aggression pact I can deal with. So after Gid's kind of moving through some of my puppet state territory, we may have to send an army to go deal with them. And if we beat them down, they would probably surrender. Master of State. So local noble seeking favor gives us a rag of fine colts to do with as we please. Engage faction politics. Did we ever see what happened on the last one? Rank gained. Matter of State. Gift speed. Huh. Well, I don't know if we ever figured out what happened on the last one. So, stud the horses. Let's see if we can do that so that maybe we can get better horses. Okay, let's spend some money to upgrade, do some public order upgrades here in Spahan. And we'll drop a couple of these buildings here, which ought to help out best in this province. They're probably experiencing some squalor, which is common in these settlements, but we probably need to upgrade these smaller cities as well. We have a little bit of money left. This force is mostly retrained. We'll probably need to... How about we take this force out ahead, go ahead and besiege Edessa, and let's continue... Well, probably start building, let's see, light siege tower, battering rams. Let's get a battering ram and some siege towers, continue the siege. Let's drop these guys back into Nisibis. Let's see, these guys are not against me, so no big concern here. I could hire in some, mercenary Persian brigade, hurlers, Persian mounted warriors would be kind of cool. Let's see what else we got here for mercenaries. Onager would be helpful. Crossbow cav, mercenaries foreign cav, that's cool. These guys could be potentially very handy. Let's check out the range on crossbow cav. I think crossbows have a slightly shorter range than bows. They do, 125. But still, these guys are going to have major armor-piercing ability, which would be cool. Just not sure if I need them just yet. These Persian scouts could be handy. They have really good capture power, and they're very fast. And I wonder if they're considered raiders. Like if they can burn down buildings. Immune to desert attrition, resistant to fatigue, guerrilla deployment... Ignores terrain. And they have rapid advance as well. Let's hold off here until we've sieged a little longer so that I'm not wasting upkeep cost. Let's see where those Africans are at up here. So it looks like they're trying to threaten one of my client states up here. So we may want to send an army over to teach those guys a lesson. But I don't know if the public order in Spahan can really handle the absence of this army at this point. Let's see what we're able to recruit in Spahan. No. Let's go to this army and just... What do we can only just do Armenian spears. No, not what I meant to do. Yeah, not really going to be able to get the kind of army I want to come deal with these guys. Let's just hold off and see if those guys really become much of a threat. I'm not really concerned about them at the moment. Just putting this on all my characters to boost public order wherever they may be at for now. And let's go ahead and end the turn. See my income climbing, even though I'm building my forces. So should be building up quite the little income here. I did forget to check on the diplomacy to see if there's other folks we can trade with. I'll double check that, because we do have access to spices and some of the other things that would be handy to trade, I think. And I do like how on this screen, too, they've changed the factions you're at war with to being red. Gassanids are suing for peace already. And I'll accept their peace treaty because I have no desire to come down here into Arabia Magna at this point. It's not going to be worth my time, and it's not very fertile as far as a province goes.
Would have me propose a treaty between us.
I still don't want the defensive alliance. And I have some puppet states moving troops up closer to the front line, which could potentially be handy. Okay. And it looks like Atropatene sent up some forces to do some raiding in the Roman lands where I have them besieged, so that's interesting to see the client states actually pitching a hand. And it looks like these guys appear under siege, but I'm not sure if Africans can pull that off. We've got a number of turns before we still have siege equipment here. Edessa is going to have... I don't know if we can get a look at their... how many units we're going to be up against. I don't guess that functionality is still here. We can always just do this. So, a couple of cohorts. Cohorts, not quite as good as cohorts. Cohorts. I'm sure there's going to be some jokes about that. Sagittari. So, it's like we're busy constructing still. Situation laying siege, so disease doubles the chance of outbreak. That sucks. Enemy disease. So, that's cool. It kind of shows you all these features over here. Very nice indeed. And I think this shows you the terrain, like what you'd be facing from the city. So, that's very nice. I think that was there in Rome too as well. I just never did manage to use it. So, let's just continue the siege for now. We've got the Romans where we want them, and this raiding over here is going to really screw things up for the Romans even further. Let's check it out. We've got quite a bit of money. Let's go over here to Spahan again and see if there's anything else we can do to further improve public order. We got these workshops here, which is giving us some wealth. These gold veins, it is 600 wealth. I'd hate to give that up, but it also does add to our squalor. So really, we just need to get the growth going, and once we hit 7, I'll build some sanitation structure here, and that should help balance out the rest of the province nicely, actually. We can do a public order boost here as well, and then that'll get this army free to where we can go over go after the Afrigids if we need to. Let's see, up here, let's build some fields, and then we'll do a noble estate here, just to boost the public order in this province, because it's going to be suffering soon enough whenever we finish taking it over. And I think we have time to end one more turn. Okay. Western Romans apparently busy on their turn ends, and who can blame them? They have an extremely difficult campaign to carry out. The Sassanids is very easy compared to the Romans.
We beg for a treaty between our peoples.
Are these guys my puppet state? I'm pretty sure that these are all puppet states. Let's go ahead and just make a defensive alliance with these guys. Get some money out of it at the same time. Looks like I've now got maybe potential reinforcements in the siege against East Romans at Edessa. Not that I really feel like we have to have it, but maybe a good time to attack. Yeah, we've got two reinforcing armies, so we should attack Edessa. This is going to be pretty brilliant. Let's go ahead and fight. I've got some siege equipment. My AI reinforcements are going to have to come in and try and burn down gates or something. Edessa is looking like a small settlement here. If I can get my cataphracts into the city, these guys are dead meat. Kate, let's start the deployment.
Keep to maintain and speedy in their.
I would rather not use the battering rams, given a choice.
To set fire to a besieged settlement.
But maybe I would.
However,
I don't
they
know.
Must be closely watched, as they are impetuous and unruly, and may act without orders. Burning a settlement affects it.
Okay, so the guy was trying to give me some advice, basically just talking about raiders and how they play into the game. We may want to try and draw some fire with our Persian bowmen. Let's keep our Varan cataphracts back here. Yeah, let's just kind of get these guys up a little closer. Go ahead and start the battle, see if we can get our light siege towers actually on the walls. We're going to take a lot of fire on the way in, so again, let's use our bowmen to come up here and draw some fire. Okay, my archers are going to be the ones drawing fire at this point. That's okay, they're cheaper units. And we don't want these enemy Sagittari firing at flaming arrows at our towers, which is a bigger concern for me. go ahead and attack these Sagittarii. Hit precision shot. So we can increase our damage. Probably should have waited until all my guys were already firing before hitting precision shot. So hopefully maximize any damage that I do against them, but I don't expect my accuracy to be super good from beneath the walls and firing into the wall, but we are causing some damage. And we are drawing fire, all of which is going to be important here. All these towers, they're going to do a number on our siege tower with fire damage. And maybe since all this firing's going on, we really should go ahead and push up. A battering ram while the fire is being drawn on my archers. Part of me is considering just letting my archers die. I can retrain them. It's not a particularly big scare for me. And we are doing a lot of damage to the enemy Sagittarii. And they're also running low on ammo, which means they're going to have a hard time burning my siege towers to the ground. That's good. We'll have reinforcing spears ready to go up the siege towers as well. Keep our general to safe distance. So, yep. Definitely getting a piece of the enemy Sagittarii. The Persian bows, not bad units. Not bad units indeed. Looks like we got a fair amount of ammo on these guys too. We've actually routed the enemy Sagittarii. Let's start focusing on the exploratores. Exploratores, yeah, I guess. These guys are going to have pretty poor armor and missile block chance because they're a scout unit. And any damage I can do to them outside of melee is going to be great. Let's see how our towers are doing from fire damage standpoint. 26% on this one. 34% here. We're going to have to keep an eye on that. Okay, we are now firing away at the exploratories. We have to just, again, keep an eye on the fire damage here. If it gets too high, we may have to abandon it. It's a little easier to burn towers down here, and the enemy Sagittarii came back from routing and are actually adding some extra fire damage here as well. I'm gonna let my men go ahead and start to disembark from here, though. Let's move up more Armenian spears. Let's go ahead and move up Armenian spears here, where it looks like we're gonna be able to get up that tower. These Armenian spears are gonna be in rough shape. They're gonna be pretty badly matched against these cohorts here. We're not actually getting any capture there as well, and we're up to 100% fire damage, so we don't want to send any more men up here. These men are going to be lucky to get out of there, and we're probably going to get our men killed at this point. Let's cease fire, because we're probably just hitting our own men, and let's actually switch to flaming, target the scout equites. This siege tower over here is actually now up to 100% fire damage as well. So, not good. These guys will probably have time to get off here, though, and let's try and get into the capture point quickly. We want to take these towers away from the enemy. Might not have hurt to hire an Onager crew. We're doing okay in the fight, though. Enemy gate is open, even though we're battering it. So we're battering the dust out of the air, I guess. Okay, my archers are getting a hold of the scout equites, so that's working out. And we managed to get most of our men off of that tower before it crumbled. So let's get some more men into the capture point. Maybe come around here and attack these guys in the rear. The gates are about to give way.
The enemy have rallied their units.
Attack these cohorts in the back. We're not actually able to out-capture the units that are in this zone, so the enemy's going to maintain possession of their towers. We're about to rout the scout equites, though, with our archer fire.
The enemy gates are obliterated.
Good. So now we can get another unit in through the gates, and we lost our battering ram at the same time. But this may give us enough capture power to get in here. The enemy scouts are now dead. We've got more Armenian spears coming up. We still don't have enough capture power to overcome probably these exploratores up here that are going to give us the most problem capture power-wise, because they're scout units and they're usually good at capturing. So that's what the, when they give those unit statistics and they say good capture power, that's what it means. We should be able to potentially get our cataphracts in the gate as well. Unfortunately, we're losing some men. There's a lot of tower fire, so this is going to be... Towers are going to be very powerful in this game. Very powerful. You can see they're getting like machine gun like rates of fire out of these things. Pull our archers back. All of our remaining Armenian spearmen are coming in.
We are at your command. Quick march.
Excuse me. We'll see if we get enough capture power once I get all these Armenian spears in here.
Our spears are yours.
Let's go attack this cohort with this one.
The men are broken and running for their lives.
Yeah, we still don't have enough capture power to overcome the Romans here, so apparently the Armenian spears, not very good capture power, and we probably should have brought some scout units in to help with this. Let's bring our cataphracts up as well. I'm going to be hesitant with my general, because there's a lot of tower fire, and I don't want him dead. But you can see we're still not getting any luck on capturing the towers, but we did just get rid of a cohort's unit, so that actually balance the difference, so now we are getting capture on the towers, and with our cataphracts inbound, that ought to seal the deal. So the towers are going to drop, and this is probably the last of the enemy resistance. Though I'm going to go ahead and just run my cataphracts for the town center, because my spearmen ought to mop this up just fine. Yeah, these towers have killed a fair number of my men. Yep, got my cataphracts just burning, turning for the main square. Okay, all the Roman units have routed and we destroyed their towers because we captured them. So now my Tsvaran cataphracts are headed in. And we're out of range of this tower, so we're just going to keep it that way. Approaching it would just get a whole bunch more of my guys killed. So the enemy general is still alive. Let's push up these units this way, so that we can outflank these, they're probably limit tiny bodyguard. Okay, yeah, I want you to come over here, actually. I'm misclicking pretty badly right now. There we go. If we can lure these guys down to where I can get a charge on them, I certainly don't want to charge them uphill in a confined space.
Our forces have found their courage. Back to the fight.
Okay, got some of my Armenian spears back in the fight. Is there some reason why my guys aren't pathfinding through? Oh, there's a barricade. I was like, what's going on? Like, my guys aren't pathfinding. Forgot there's a barricade. Or I didn't look to see that there was a barricade, I should say. So we'll have to destroy the barricade. So my guys are going to tear the barricade down, which the barricades don't seem to be quite strong enough to really provide any huge benefit here. Oh, that Limitani bodyguard actually just came out here. Let's pull away from it. Come here. Kind of hard to click and drag units in the city sometimes. Get some cataphracts into the main capture point. Alright, these Limitani are not braced, so we ought to get a decent charge, even though I can't get completely up to speed. Oh yeah, decent charge indeed. Let's pull back and repeat. So these Sassanid cataphracts definitely going to need a quick charge there. Let's do it again. Charge back into the unbraced border guards. I said bodyguards, my bad. We're gonna need to pull back from those bodyguards because we're getting quite a few of our cataphracts killed. Let's bring another down to charge them from behind. Brought this unit in to get a frontal charge as well. Not going to get the best charges because we're within the city, but we're going to get charge bonuses for sure. And then these guys coming around here are going to be able to clobber what's left of these border guards, and then I'm capturing the city center as well. And it looks like the last Roman unit routed, so went a little long in this episode. Should have split the siege in, but oh well, I guess you got a little bit of extra watching. So, man, 519 losses to in the siege, so getting through the cities, it's going to take some figuring out. Probably some raiding units and stuff may be helpful doing this, so we may have to look at hiring some of those guys, or just bringing like maybe a small reinforcing army that has like onagers and raiding units. That may be the right way to go. Anyway, hope y'all enjoyed it. Heir of Carthage, signing off for now.